Hello there, and as usual, I'm Aaron from Last Stand Gamers, and welcome. So recently, I've got a question or two about my utility ships, or the lack of utility ships that I tend to show. And I've shown a number of sort of drilling ships, but I never tend to show you the ships that I use to build a lot of my survival stations. And this is one that I've been using for quite a while now. Now, this is a combination of a welder and a grinder, and you'll notice that it's probably going to have some quite interesting features. Now, the idea of this ship was try to make it as compact as possible, as well as using the V-shape that will optimize the sort of drilling and grinding sort of performance. So I'll actually talk about that now. So let's extend these out. We'll hop in the cockpit, and we'll extend them out with a number 4. So you can actually see what's happening here is we've got the grinders coming on out, and then they'll lock into position here. Now, the key to having a good sort of V shape is that it'll allow us to get maximum sort of grinders on the target, so we can actually grind as much as possible and do it as fast as possible. We've also got these in a sort of spring-loaded sort of joint with the rotors here, so the rotors are going to be allowing me to put a little bit of pressure on and it'll rebound back. So I'll show you that exactly now. So let's actually fold these away one more time. I just like the folding out sort of feature. You've got the connectors on the back as well, and they're going to connect up to the center hull, and they'll resupply the welders, the grinders, as they go. If one gets full, they can empty out that way. So we're going to approach the target, we're going to open up, we're going to prepare the grinders, and we're going to conform it to the actual shape of whatever we're going to be grinding. So this is going to be pretty good. We'll add a little bit of pressure, and then all we have to do is keep adding a little bit of pressure from the rear thrusters, and we'll continue to conform around whatever we're grinding, and it'll just allow us to get as many grinders on target as possible at once, so we can get as much of this station gone. And that's just a real big importance. So as you can see, as I'm moving around, the actual grinder's going to be flexing around the target, but I'm going to actually just do a little bit of push on because we've actually gone inside the station here and there's nothing else to really grind away at. Now, there we go, we'll get something in here, we'll conform it around this sort of pillar, we'll try to get some around there. So the V shape is just a really good way of grinding a lot down, as well as keeping a sort of compact and interesting look to the ship. It almost looks like a combine harvester. So let's retract them in with 4. Now, you may have noticed that this is quite a big problem. I'm going to retract these out. These are my welders, but my cockpit is actually facing the wrong way, and controlling this inverted can be a little bit hard. I mean, you can get used to it, and I've got used to it in the past, but it's much easier to actually rotate this cockpit around. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. So the first thing I'm going to do now is hit number 7. Number 7 is going to detach me. So we detach now, and then we're going to hit number 8 to accelerate the piston. And once we're above our joint, we're going to rotate around. And we're going to go back down with the piston, and then hit number 7 to reactivate the merge blocks. We'll lock into place, and now the back is now the front. Now, I got this idea from an armored car that I saw the French sort of develop, where they had a driving wheel at the front and the back, and I thought, instead of having that, why didn't you just simply have a cockpit that sort of turns around and rotates? And from a sort of third person perspective, it looks really exciting. I'll just show you this. Let's try a rotation again. So we'll hit that, disable that, press number 8, that rises us up. We press 9 to spin us around, lock that down. Actually, I pressed the wrong button, we're going around in circles. Okay, lower that back down. And a problem that I've really noticed that's kind of a little bit annoying is that it sometimes forgets the buttons on the keypad below when you disconnect. So the main problem now is it's actually disconnected and forgot the merge buttons. So it just seems to be forgetting the actual groups that I've created. But it's something that can easily be fixed. So we can just re-enable these merge blocks. That's the problem. There we go. And that'll reconnect us back in. And all we have to do is fold away the drill. So you can see how it's gone blank at the bottom because it's actually forgot the location or whatever the group is called. I think it personally just keeps deleting the groups because the groups are just no longer here at all. So if we go down to our actual rotors and we get 3 and 4 and we reverse them in, that should lock them back into place. So it's actually very movable, very storable as well, because a lot of grinding and welding ships tend to be very sort of obscure shapes, long and wide, where this one you can fit in a nice square sort of hangar. Anyway, I just thought I'd share with you some interesting sort of cockpit spin around, as well as this sort of multi-tool sort of design of a utility ship. I'd like to thank you guys for watching, and hopefully it's inspired you to build something a little bit different.